Here we're going to look at how to solve equations involving fractional expressions. Consider this example here, x over 6 plus 2 over 3 equals 3x over 4. The goal is to solve for x so that this equation is satisfied. Namely, to find the value of x that will actually make this equation true. So for example, if you stick in x equal to 0, will you get this equation as a true statement? Well, 0 over 6 plus 2 over 3 is that the same as 3 times 0 over 4? Well, that's saying 0 plus 2/3 equals 0. Well, certainly is not a true statement, which means that 0 is not a solution to this equation. So you want to come up with a systematic way of finding all such x values that will make this equation a true statement. That's our goal. And the idea for doing this is going to be convert all fractions so that all of them have the same least common denominator. Once we have them all in the same LCD form, then we can just combine the top portion and set it into an equation. So in this equation, to get LCD, I need to first factor all of them into its prime factors form. Okay, so for 6, I can factor them into 2 and 3. I can factor the 4 into 2 squared. 3 is already a prime number. It doesn't need any more factorization. So my LCD is, remember, it's going to be all distinct factors among all fractions. I have to have a 2, and it has to have a 3, and it has to have nothing else, basically, because 2 and 3 are really the distinct factors among those three terms. And then we look for the highest power for each distinct factor. So the factor 2, this is a power 1, but this one here has power 2 because of this 2 here. So I need to have a power of 2 for the factor 2. For 3, this is a power of 1, and this is also a power of 1, which means that I'll only just need a power of 1 on the 3. This means my LCD is 12. I sometimes don't like to actually multiply the LCD out because I like to look for what's missing when I convert each fractions into the LCD form. So for example, if I go back to my expression of the x over 6, and I compare that to my LCD of 2 squared times 3. 6 is factored into 2 and 3, so when I compare, I notice that, well, it's got the 3 already there. It's got the 2 there. It's missing another factor of 2 because the power in 6 is 1, but the power in the LCD is 2. So I know what's missing really is an extra 2. So I just need 2 here and 2 there. For my second expression here, of the denominator 3, I compare that to my LCD. Well, it's got the 3 in there already, but what's missing is this 2 squared, which is 4. So I do a times 4 and times a 4. For my last fraction here, I have a 4, which is 2 squared. So I've got the 2 squared from the LCD checked, but I'm missing a 3 there. So that means I need to multiply by a 3, top and the bottom. So by not multiplying out to 12, I can easily examine and check to see what the factors are missing. Now I'm ready to rewrite. So the first fraction I have 2x divided by 12. The second fraction now becomes 8, because that's 2 times 4, divided by 12. The third fraction on the right here is going to be 3 times 3x, which is 9x, divided by 12. Now you notice that every single fraction has the same denominator, so I can just add the top portions and set them equal. So on the left-hand side, I have a 2x plus a on top. On the right-hand side, I have 9x on top. Because they're all over the same denominator, and you can just kind of ignore that. So really, I just have the equation 2x plus 8 equals 9x. Essentially, I'm just looking at the top portion of those fractions and see what information that's given me. Okay, but once that's out of the fractional form, we can solve this problem as we would normally do for either linear or quadratic polynomials. This is a linear problem, so I'm going to isolate my x by moving the 2x to the right-hand side. So that gives me a 7x when I subtract 2x both sides, and we'll have an 8 on the left-hand side as a constant, which simply just divided by 7 gives me the solution, it's 8 over 7. A lot of the times you wanted to go back and check to see the solution that you got at the end actually makes sense to your problem, because we're talking about fractions here. So if it turns out that when you plug it in back into the original expressions, you get some sort of undefined answer, then that means we can't actually take this solution. But because all of our fractions have a numerical denominator, everything here is going to be well-defined. We don't have to worry about that. Let's consider this example next. 1 over x plus 1 plus 1 over x minus 2 all equals to x plus 3 divided by x squared minus x minus 2. Pause the video for a minute or so. Try to do this yourself and come back for answer. I'm going to start by factoring the denominator on the right-hand side here. That's going to be x plus 1 times x minus 2. And look for the LCD among all fractions. Distinct factors are x plus 1 and x minus 2. Each one of those factors actually appear at the highest power of 1. Kind of an alternative strategy to do this is to multiply through every single factor by the LCD. And that's essentially doing what we did before by first converting every fraction into the LCD form and then deal with the numerator. But you actually get the same effect simply just by multiplying every single term by the LCD. Okay, so if you take the first expression here and multiply by the LCD, you'll notice that the x plus 1 would cancel. I'll just write it on the side for you and you'll see it. I'm going to do x plus 1 times x minus 2 here. See, this is really like that. So the x plus 1 that appears in the denominator will cancel all the x plus 1 that appears on the top. So effectively, you're really accomplishing here is just taking the 1 from the numerator and then times the missing term, which is x minus 2. Now, if you take the second fraction here and multiply by the LCD, you'll notice that the x minus 2 would cancel, and the missing term would then be the x plus 1. So I have plus 1 times the x plus 1. So the plus comes from that, the 1 comes from this. And that's going to be equal to the right-hand side. When I multiply this third expression here by the LCD, you'll notice that the entire denominator cancels out with the LCD, so you're left with just x plus 3 on top. So notice that by multiplying every single term by the LCD, you're getting rid of the fractional form all at once. So this reduces down to an expression that is free of fractions. And then just becomes a linear problem to solve. We have x minus 2 plus x plus 1 all equal to x plus 3. The left-hand side gives me 2x, and I subtract the another x from the right to the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, I have a 3, and if I move the constant, a negative 2 plus 1 on the left, which I combine it first into a negative 1 and move it to the right, I just need to add 1 both sides. So this gives me x equals 4. Now you want to check to see if you plugging x equals 4 back into the original equation actually makes sense. Wherever you see an x, I'm going to plug in a 4. So I get 1 over 4 plus 1, which is 5, plus 1 over 4 minus 2, which is a 2. Is that really equal to 4 plus 3, which is 7, divided by 4 squared minus 4 minus 2? Well, that's actually easier if we do it in the factor form. That's 4 plus 1 times a 4 minus 2, which is 5 times 2, and that gives us 10. So this becomes 7 over 10. And indeed, if you get a common denominator from here, which would be a 10, and you would get 2 plus a 5 on top, that is equal to 7 tenths. That means x equals 4 is a solution to this equation. I'm going to give you one more example of extra practice here. I have 2 plus 5 over x minus 4 equals x plus 1 divided by x minus 4 here. Again, pause for a minute or so and do the back for answers. Here I've got the LCD to be x minus 4, so I'm going to multiply every single term by the LCD. So it gives me 2 times the LCD, which is x minus 4, plus, this plus, the 5 times the LCD. Well, that x minus 4 cancels out with this x minus 4 in the denominator, so I simply just have a plus 5. On the right-hand side, if I multiply this by x minus 4, it will also cancel out with the denominator, so I just have x plus 1 left. So this gives me the equation 2x minus 8 plus 5 equals x plus 1. On the left-hand side, I will have 2x minus 3. Let's just move everything to the left here. Subtract x, I subtract 1, all set equal to 0. So I have x minus 4 equals 0. So that means x is equal to 4. Now if I now put x equals 4 back into my original expressions, notice that we would get the equation 2 plus 5 over 0 equals 5 over 0. Well, does that actually make sense? Can you actually do a division by 0? And the answer is no, we can't do division by 0 because that's undefined. Which means that the only solution we got, which was x equals 4, doesn't work for this equation. Which means that this equation has no solution. You can probably justify it by writing the following. You can say that x equals 4 makes the left-hand side shorthanded by the LHS, which is 2 plus 5 over 0, and the right-hand side, which is 5 over 0, undefined. Hence, this equation has no solution. So as a rule of thumb, every time when you get to the end of a problem that involves fractional expressions, you want to go back and check to see the solution you got actually makes sense.